Hello and welcome to the Rutiger Cross Country Complex in Krasnoyarsk. It's the final day of competition at the 2019 Winter Universiade. An overcast day, but conditions are mild. And as always, the wax technicians have got such an important job to do. Even more important in a long race, the wax eventually gives way. And so they'll do the best job they can to send their athletes out on the right surface for the prevailing conditions. Not had any snow the last couple of days, so the course will be as it has been. It was used yesterday for the women's 15K, and a big field is making its way out to the start area. We're just a couple of minutes away from beginning this longest of the men's races. In this cycle of the Universiade, it'll be the freestyle. 2 years ago, it was a classic technique. 76 competitors from 22 countries. Russian Federation looking to dominate the top places, but they'll get a good opposing campaign from the likes of Japan, Kazakhstan, Switzerland, France and Austria, all with multiple entries. The Russian Federation has a full team of six in. That's the maximum number. Snow temperature has risen in the last few days. It was minus six, so that will be factored into the waxing of the skis. Wind from the west at 2.5 meters per second. That seems to have been the prevailing direction. And there are the starting bibs. So the Russian Federation, Yakimushkin, can he make it a fourth gold medal for himself? And can it be another 1-2-3 for the Russian Federation? Well, all these skiers will be trying to get amongst it. As we get to the bottom half of the field, they'll really just be looking for a personal best performance and the opportunity to take part in this last cross-country race at Rutiger. We are away in the 30K mass start for the men freestyle. Eight laps, four on the red course, four on the blue. And each lap 3.75 kilometres long. As they head out of the stadium for the first time at a good clip two, and off to the right there in three is Ivan Kirillov. Good strong family tradition in cross-country skiing. His father was an international skier. The first non-Russian with the lowest bib is Naoto Baba of Japan. And he's a 22-year-old from Tokyo. So there's the wind just disturbing the flags and the standards. It's around, but it should not be enough to upset the athletes on the trickier sections of the course. There's been one or two falls in these cross-country races around the quicker sections. The athletes just looking to settle into a comfortable rhythm. And taking the early running there, Fabio Lechner of Switzerland. And then in 11, Louis Schwartz of France. Schwartz going out reasonably briskly. He's from the University of Grenoble-Alpes. Very important in the first few minutes just not to get tangled up in something. I mean, you don't win the race on the first lap, but you can just about lose it if you have a big fall. We saw that in the women's race when Ursula Latocha of Poland, who was in the lead group, tumbled out of contention on a fast right-hand descent, and she never really recovered. Klyevnyuk now has caught the leaders. They've just pulled back Lechner and Schwartz to the main pack, and off to the side there was Kolistek for a moment. He was looking for a drink. Yes, I think he was. That's one of the first drink stations. As has been the case right through with these games that started 10 days ago, the conditions unexpectedly mild this time of year in Krasnoyarsk. central Siberia. Population of 2.8 million, but much more than that in the greater region. Krasnoyarsk towards the south of central Siberia. Not so very far from northern Mongolia. Trans-Siberian Railway passes through Krasnoyarsk. Number four there, Naoto Baba of Japan takes up the running for the moment. And Baba from Senshu University. An institution founded in 1923, so not far away from their 100th anniversary. I'm sure there'll be some timely celebrations at Senshu University. Solitary figure out on the course now. Has he managed to shake off Klyivnyuk? Well, he has. Klyivnyuk is well behind him. And this is a really interesting development while we're showing you some of the rest of the field. And Poroshkin, he can see his teammate there and he can see the chance for a silver medal. He's not far behind and looks like he's found something. He's certainly making an effort. But so too is Baba. He's cleared out from Klyivnyuk, so it could be a Japanese gold medal here. Oh, talk him into it too early, but he looks to be in great form. No sign of trouble, no clear evidence of him wearying, fatiguing. So the 25.5K. Let's see the gap between Baba and his chasers. Baba's got a 15-second gap over Klyivnyuk, and then Poroshkin just 3 seconds behind his teammate. So Poroshkin, his determination could be rewarded here. Klyivnyuk is fading. Not only could he not keep pace with Baba, but he's falling back into the clutches of Poroshkin. Well, quite a few Japanese fans have come to Radiga today to see if they can sneak a medal or something out of this last day of cross-country. Well, they're going to be delighted to see the gap that Baba has established as he comes into the stadium again. It's Baba on his own. Well, in some ways, he deserves to win this. He's not done yet. It's a 30K race, but the Japanese team, I've got to feel pretty good about his chances. Klyivnyuk, followed by Poroshkin. No sign of Yakimushkin, who was wearing the number one bib at the start of this race. The pace got too hot for him. ...16 seconds now between second and first. The Russian Federation being shown the way here by a 22-year-old from Japan. And Baba heads out of the stadium once more. He's on his last lap. So too these men. And they're going to turn this into quite an interesting race for second and third. But hopes of another Russian Federation clean sweep have disappeared. This fine race skied by Baba. So Klyivnyuk, Poroshkin, second and third. Then Klemin of Kazakhstan. Then back to Yakimushkin, who's drifted a minute back now. That margin has opened up very quickly. He's skiing alongside Kazadinov of the Russian Federation. All smiles amongst the Japanese supporters. As Kazadinov and Yakimushkin and Klemin come through. So 2 years ago, Japan finished fifth in this race through Hikan Fujinoki, and seventh through Akihito Uda, who is skiing today, but not in contention. It's his teammate, Naoto Baba, who's going to grab the headlines back home. If this man can continue to do what he's done for the last hour and 3 minutes. And for about 55 of those minutes, he has been the leader. And now he's managed to clear out from the Russian team. Kilyevnyuk and Poroshkin. Well, they can generate some pace trying to win their own little battle. And I don't know if they've got the time or the energy to get near Baba. There'll be sections and turns on the course where he can look over his shoulder and see whether they're gaining on him. But he's also got team officials out on the course to tell him how he's going, what the margin is. And it was 16 and a half seconds when they came through 26.1 Ks. We'll look forward to the next checkpoint to see if that gap has widened. It's a beautiful course, but it's a testing one. Some tricky turns, some testing climbs. Poroshkin now leading Kilyevnyuk. And there's a drink for Kilyevnyuk. He was the last man to drop off the pace set by Baba. Yakimushkin climbing now. And Kazarinov. His head dropping a bit. It's quite a distance between the 26.1K checkpoint and the next at 28 and a half. And when they come through our next checkpoint, there'll only be 1,500 meters for Baba to ski. Yakimushkin sitting in fourth position, and then the first athlete from Kazakhstan, Olzas Klimin. Kazarinov looks a bit spent. Wouldn't mind a bit of refreshment, though. I'll go around and clean up the discarded bottles. In due course, Strubel seems to have been skiing on his own for quite a while now. Back to Anton Timashov. He's in about seventh position. Jan Korostek. Both these men were in the lead group for the first half of the race. And it's about fatigue and stamina and what you've got to give on the day. Korostek looks exhausted as he drops into the tuck. And here's Nikita Gridin. Following him up the hill, Joel Ikkonen of Finland, and 16, Nail Bashmakov. Moritz Lotza of Switzerland. Got a couple of times I can bring you here. Baba at the 28.5K checkpoint has stretched his lead to 39 seconds over Poroshkin and Kilyevnyuk. So Baba is stretching them. That's happening away from the pictures we're showing you now. We do like to give everybody a bit of a moment. But there it is, the 39-second lead for Baba through 28.5K as well. He's making the race his own. He's done so much of the hard work leading the field, and his pace has burnt them off one by one. We're so used to the events here at Rutiger being played out principally by Russian athletes in front,
третьем пункте. Иван Якимушкин, Team Russia.
Russian Federation having won 23 of the 30 medals distributed so far. They know what's going on here. The big screen and the public address let everybody know the story of the race. They only get to see the athletes for a minute or so as they come into and then leave the stadium. There's not a lot more to do for this man. Is he going to enjoy this moment when he comes into the stadium and finds that he's still got a big lead and he can really savour the occasion? Just be careful around this fast right-hander. He is. He negotiates it once more. So he's had some good results over 50 Ks as well. He doesn't mind the long distances. Mainly in freestyle, mass start events and national championships and in open company back home. So I think we're going to see Naoto Baba, who's only 22, around for a fair bit longer. Might be challenging in future years and events some of the stronger nations in open company. So Baba, his lead over Kolivniuk. Let's check it out as Kolivniuk has his own race with Poroshkin. 33 seconds. Well, it's Babar's to lose from here, and I don't think he will. The finish line is too close. And into the stadium he comes. Naoto Baba. Skiing towards Japan's first gold medal of the cross-country program. They've had a silver already in a relay event for the women, but now Baba skiing effortlessly, it seems. The prospect of this victory giving him more energy. The Japanese flag waved just for him as he skates towards the line. Naoto Baba, an unexpected victory, but a very welcome one for him and his university and his country. So Baba from Senshu University in Tokyo secures the win in the men's 30K mass start freestyle. Around the bend now comes Kirill Kolivniuk. Krasnoyarsk local pushing hard towards the line. Silver will be his. And bronze also to the Russian Federation as Ilya Poroshkin comes across the line.
Thank you.
Looks like he could barely blow out a candle. He's super fit, is Naoto Baba. Well, very entertaining. Nice to see a spread of nations picking up medals. And this is going to be gold to Japan. Silver and bronze to the Russian Federation. The event conducted in terrific conditions.
Имеется заслуженная победа на финише тем временем.
confirming that Baba of Japan has won it, the men's 30K freestyle from Klyuvnyuk and Poroshkin of the Russian Federation. It's a great day for Baba, Klyuvnyuk and Poroshkin, Japan and the Russian Federation after the men's 30K mass start. I do hope you enjoyed not only this race, but the other 10 events we've had at Radiga. All the best to you all. Goodbye for now from Krasnoyarsk.